All right, so what we have here is we have some particle moving along by a law of motion, right? And it gives an equation, f of t. And it's third order, t cubed minus 12t squared plus 36t. It gives a domain of t starting at 0 because time can't be negative. And it says, gives some instructions. It says, find the acceleration, graph all three functions, velocity, position, and acceleration. And then the thing we want to concentrate on today is when is it speeding up, when is it slowing down? And we got to be careful about that question. That's going to take a lot of thought. I'm going to go through everything today. And first thing I'm going to do is, does everybody see that t is common in the position function? So everybody, first thing I would do is pull out the t and see it's a quadratic. And then I see the quadratic factors in the t minus 6 squared. So automatically, I know two things about this particle, all right? I know that at time 0 and time 6, the position is 0. I know S of t, put this in black so it matches because I have colors on the next page. I know S of t equals 0 at time equals 0 and 6. All right? Awesome. Part A, you know, I'm not really working part A right now. Part A is just finding acceleration, which we know is derivatives. So I'm going to keep going now, but I know this back. I'm going to save that for the graphs. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the derivative. We should be able to look at this function, use the power rule, and get the derivative. And I'm not going to waste time working at that. We're good at this. T cubed is, negative 12t squared is negative 24t, and 36t is 36. And look, we get a quadratic, and you know I want a book problem because I'm going to factor out the 3. And then, look, I get a quadratic, and I can factor out the 2 times and get 2 binomials. And again, for the graph, I could say, hey, I know when v of t is 0. It's at time equals 2 and time equals 6. All right, so now I got some other information. Now, I'm finally getting to the point. It said, hey, find the acceleration at time t. I'll take the derivative of this function right here, right? And again, you guys probably could see it in your head, but I already did it. And I got, derivative of 3t squared is 6t, derivative of negative 24t is negative 24, and derivative of 36 is 0. And I factored that, and, all right? And factoring that was 6 times t minus 4. All right, awesome. So now I know, that the acceleration is 0 at time equals 4 seconds. These are all in seconds. All right? So this is just letter A, and I've done some extra work, because if I go back a little bit, because what A asked for was find the acceleration at time t. Boom, I did that, didn't I? A of t equals 6t. Well, I really had, for sure I had to do this, and then I could have got to this. But I'm going to need everything else to do part B, the graphing. How'd you get S of t was given to me up here, and I factored out the t, all right, because t was common, all right? So, but now I sit here, it says find the acceleration of time t, boom, awesome, and after 3 seconds. Oh, I can do 3 seconds. What's A of 3? Put it in, 18 minus 24, how about negative 6, and this was in meters, so it's in meters per second squared, meters per second per second, the rate of change of the velocity. So I just did letter A. Letter A is these two parts right here.
Mr. Applewood.
Yes.
Why is there?
Took the derivative of position. The rate of change of position with respect to time is meters per second. That is velocity. The rate of change of velocity is acceleration.
That's right, I'm bad with math vocabulary, so I don't understand.
All right, so how do I have math vocabulary? You're gonna have.
I've always got along with knowing how to do the math, not knowing the words.
Yeah, you're screwed. Learn the words. You gotta do some homework. I can't even get you caught up. Do you understand what the derivative is?
Sort of.
Alright.
Then again, not really.
Okay, so listen, right now, because you're kind of caught with derivative, the derivative is the rate of change, alright, at any given instant. So if I'm finding the rate of change of position, it's velocity. Because position is in meters, what are we going to measure our position in with respect to time, right? So you have meters, rate of change with respect to time, meters per second. So its derivative, using the power rule, is going to be velocity. All right? So that's going to lead us to that equation. And again, you got to use the power rule. And again, you're trying to memorize rules. So I appreciate that. But you can't, you're going to have to go back and work some of these problems and get the vocabulary down. All right? So, let me show you the graph. Let's work from there, all right? Because the next thing, it says graph the position of velocity, position, and acceleration function from 0 to 8. All right? So, I've created all these beautiful functions. And if I go to a dual page, I already put up this great graph picture, okay? And we know some stuff. We took some time over here to find the zeros, right? We found the zeros for position. We found the zeros for velocity. And we found the zero for acceleration off of these points. So they're easy points to graph. All right? I'm going to work from bottom up. And the reason I'm going to work from bottom up is what's easier to graph? 16 minus 24? Or 3t squared minus 24t plus 36, or way back up here, t cubed minus 12t squared plus 36t. The easiest thing to graph is the line, right? And we know at time equals 4, we got a point there, all right? At 0, I plug 0 in for time. Guys, you guys agree that the y-intercept's negative 24? And what's 8? You plug in 8, 48 minus 24 is 24. Ah, because it said go time 8. The one that's just, that's the point. I'm going to put 3 points up. All right. And we got this here. We got that acceleration. All right. All right, everybody. That line is, we should look at that line. Positive slope, right? 16 minus 24. Does everybody agree this particle is getting faster and faster and faster? That's the acceleration, okay, Tony? So now, that's the rate of change. So what's happening to the velocity? The acceleration started off negative, goes to zero, and then goes positive. So whatever the velocity is, it's going to be going slower and slower and slower, and then it's going to go faster and faster and faster. I'm going to take and plot the next curve, which is this curve. And again, everybody, what kind of shape is 3t squared minus 24t plus 36? It's a parabola. And I know two zeros, 2 and 6. Guys, I can plug these 2 points. And we remember that a parabola has an axis of symmetry, right? So if I know 2 and 6, the midpoint is 4. If I plug 4 back into this equation, I can figure out the bottom. All right? And actually, I'll plug 4 and 6 into here and get 3 times 2 times negative 2, which is negative 12. So at 4, we're at negative 12. I plug in 0, right? That's 36, and I know it's symmetrical, so at 8 it has to be 36. All right, this is where it's starting to get tough. Does everybody see where the red curve has a derivative of 0? Does everybody see where the instantaneous rate of change of the red curve is 0? How about right there? And what's the value of its derivative? 0. All right, this is tough. Again. All right, but there's our velocity curve. And it's just what we said. The velocity initially started at 36, and while the acceleration was negative, the velocity came down. All right? Now, the black position, the position curve, is a lot more work. We know it's 0 at 0 and 6. All right? And actually, I know the derivative at 2 is 0. everybody, I know this curve has to look like this, because at this point, I know the tangent line had to be zero, because the derivative, the velocity is zero. And then it goes down, and it goes like that. All right, that's what the curve looks like. We'll go through here. Oh, I got it. Bring back. Yeah, so we're going to talk about this. This is hard, all right? And this is why we're going to do a couple examples and really work at this. All right? Everybody, again, high velocity in red, right? Starting up here, high velocity. So it is, it started at position zero. So obviously it starts running away. And all of a sudden, it starts going less fast. Why? Because the velocity is a smaller value. Initially it was going 36, so it's, you know, the rate of change is changing. But then all of a sudden it's going 0 meters per second right here, right? And what happens at 0 meters per second? The position stops. Then what happens? In between here, velocity is negative. So what happens to position? It goes backwards, right? And it goes backwards until it stops again. And by that, by coincidence, when it stopped, the position is zero again. And then what happens? The velocity is positive, the acceleration is positive, and what happens to the particle? It starts speeding up, running away. So that's the graph, all right? Now, what's really tough about this, we're going to get rid of all this blue crap. What's really tough about this now is, whoops, is part C. Part C is hard, all right? And we don't want to confuse it. Part C says, when is the particle speeding up? When is it slowing down? It is not asking about the velocity. It's asking about the speed. So let's be clear. Where is the velocity positive and negative? Zero to two, it's positive. Six to eight, it's positive. All right, where is it negative? Obviously between two and six. But everybody, if you've ever driven a car, it's asking when it's speeding up. So we're going to go to a single page here. It is asking about when you speed up. Guys, if you're driving in reverse and you push the accelerator, you are speeding up in reverse. Your velocity is negative and you're accelerating. If you start pushing the brake, you are no longer speeding up. You're still going in reverse really fast, but now instead of going 20 miles an hour backwards, you're going 15, 10. You're no longer speeding up. So the question is, when is the velocity positive and the acceleration positive, or when is the velocity negative and the acceleration negative? When do they match up? Well, in gold, I'm going to mark this. This is an acceleration positive, a velocity positive. Is the acceleration positive? No. All right. So there's our first no. Let's go to the next section. My velocity is negative. Whoops, I want to change colors. My velocity is negative. My acceleration is negative. Read the values. Guess what? This is the reverse-reverse situation. I am speeding up, but I am speeding up going backwards. So this is in reverse. So from 2 to 4, we are speeding up. Now, look what happens, though, at 4. You stop speeding up, right? You were going 20 miles an hour backwards. You let off the gas, and you start pushing the brake. The acceleration is now positive forward. So guess what? Between here and here, positive acceleration, negative velocity. But then what happens in the last section again? Positive, positive, 6 to 8. So when are we speeding up? We're speeding up in the interval 2 to 4 and 6 to 8. And it's really tough, because it's a different question. Speed and velocity are different. Speed and velocity are different. And we will go through that again. Yeah, you got to study this. And 20 terminology is going to make a big difference. There is no easy way to say this. All right? And you got to do homework. And you got to do odds. If you are simply doing the problems I assign, that is not going to be enough homework, most likely. All right?